I went into a restaurant one time back in Australia. Not all of them are halal, right? Entered, and I looked at the businessman. He's got pictures of, I won't mention because of particular nationality, which are undesirable. He's got alcohol serving. And I thought, subhanAllah, someone brought me there. I asked, I said, brother, is the food halal? He said, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. He's trying to say that, look, I'm saying Alhamdulillah, meaning I'm Muslim and everything is halal. Alhamdulillah on what? Alhamdulillah that I'm serving alcohol, that I'm earning wealth from haram. Alhamdulillah that I am making an environment for something where the shaitan can come in. Alhamdulillah that I am spending my money on haram and earning it from haram. Alhamdulillah only when it involves money, but not Alhamdulillah when Allah has guided me to salat and fasting. There are people who don't pray at all, who don't fast at all, who don't even have the Islamic character at all in any way, but when it comes to money, Alhamdulillah all the time. Subhanallah, I will recite the whole Quran for you if it involves money. Yes? So suddenly I become a good Muslim when it involves ni'mah, blessing, money, wealth. But little do we know and remember that not a single cent of it, not a single bit of it, not a single penny of it can come to us if it wasn't for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who willed it. Allah says in the Quran, O our Lord, you lift whoever you want in honor and you deprive whoever you want and make them low whoever you will. How many people we know of who became millionaires and suddenly overnight lost it all? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran about the nature of the man, how weak he is and how he or she can oppress themselves. Allah says, as for the man, as for the human, as for this insan, I will tell you about him. Allah is saying, in other words, I will tell you about him. Let me introduce you to yourself because I created you. As for the man who does not know Allah, in other words, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries him or her by giving them some of his blessings, he will say, my Lord has blessed me, he loves me. Listen to the words carefully, brothers and sisters. They're a deeper meaning than what you think. Allah is saying, as for the human, I'll tell you about his nature, the evil nature of human. When we give him blessings as a trial, ibtalahu, blessings is a trial, he or she will say, my Lord has blessed me, in the sense that my Lord loves me, I am favored more than anyone else. That mentality. Not the type that says, subhanAllah, Allah has favored me and given me blessings, I thank him and I will donate from my wealth and I will remember this. No, not like that. Naturally, man, if Allah gives them, they think that Allah has blessed them in a way where they are better than other people. And I've heard this many times, repent people, they don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahi. But because they have lots of richness or whatever, they say, God must love me, therefore I don't have to pray much. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ. And if Allah tries them in another way, فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ, he makes a qadr, he wills that their rizq, their provision is cut off or restricted, he or she will say immediately, Rabbi ahanan, my Lord has humiliated me, he has left me. And they start saying things like, God is cruel, why should I worship Allah since he has humiliated me and left me like this? This is what happens. He begins to turn away. Rabbi ahanan, Allah says, kalla. He replies, kalla, a firm no. Allah says, kalla, never. I do not humiliate people just like that, nor do I give them blessings for the mere fact that they are better than anyone else. This is not how you judge a person whom Allah loves and doesn't love. بَلْ لَا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ. It is because you, many of you, as in humans, do not remember by giving blessings towards the orphans. وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. And you are not always striving to feed and look after the miskeen, the poor person. A miskeen is someone who works but doesn't have enough for their livelihood and usually doesn't ask. Tahadun, you don't search for them. You don't look for them. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا You consume wealth and money of others like it's a feast, like beasts gathering at a feast. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا And you love wealth so much beyond measure. What is Allah telling us? In other words, the only reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us when He gives us blessing and when He tests us by taking away blessing is in order to fix this disease which we have. Yes, brothers and sisters, when Allah gives us too much, we tend to forget the purpose of our life. قد كفى عمري